Hello friends, welcome to the Tetrahedron chemistry classes. So in this series, today I am going to discuss that various kinds of the terms that can be used in the ultraviolet spectroscopy. You see these groups, this will give you the pi bonding to pi antibonding. Again, this will give you the pi bonding to pi antibonding. Similarly, this will double bond again, right? Lone pairs would be there. All these things are there. And here you see this is actually this is again very common. You should know Vibor, V-I-B-G-Y-O-R, V-I say B-G-Y-O-R. This is the spectrum actually, and if you go down then you see your wavelength increases. That means lambda increases if you go from your V to R, that mean your violet to red. This is lambda max increases, right? So here I have written here, if violet is having, you see it will give you the absorption for violet color. Actually it is 400 to 420 nanometer. Now as you are moving up, so wavelength is actually increasing, and it is highest for this red color. So Vibor is particularly important for you. Fine, this is the general idea of the spectrum. Now these are the sum of the chromophores. So I am not explaining this again and again. I have explained this in the first slide, but you can take a little idea by seeing this definition. The colored substances owe their color to the presence of one or more unsaturated groups responsible for the absorption. So as I told you, it is very very important. As in UV, we are generally interested in the conjugation type of thing. So there must be the unsaturated group to act as the chromophore. Fine. So this is a model diagram for your methyl orange, right? This methyl orange, you must be knowing, it is acid base indicator, right? Actually it is a basic indicator, this methyl orange. And this is the structure of this methyl orange. You see the very good conjugation. This is the aromatic system again. This is your azo system, again aromatic system. So these transitions generally responsible for the color for this UV region. Actually the transition falls in the visible region. For this one you will absorb the color, right? So chromophores generally absorbs intensity at the shorter wavelength, right? So here I have written this one. So but some of them, if contains this carbonyl like this thing, have less intense band. So this I have explained, right? So this I have explained in the few slides back. Now these are the sum of the groups. So these are the examples I have written here, but it is not necessary and also not possible to mug out each and everything, right? You should go for concept rather than mugging all these concepts. So change in the lambda max value for these two. Now next two, say this is your hyperchromic shift, this one, and this is your hypochromic shift. You see this is epsilon value I have plotted here. This is going to increase. So if if you change the structure or the polarity of the solvent, right? So what can happen? Your epsilon max value can increase. If the epsilon max value increases, then this is known as the hyperchromic shift, right? And reversely, if your epsilon value goes down, then this is called the hyperchromic shift. But remember, this hyperchromic shift will not be very useful for us, as it will decrease your epsilon max value and your transition may become forbidden. So these are the four terms used in the UV spectroscopy. Four kinds of shifts, rather, I can say. Okay, say you have this anilinium ion and you are going to have this lambda max at 203 nanometer. But the moment you put some acid to it, sorry, to base to it, that means OH negative. If you put the OH negative to the system, clear? What could happen? Your hydrogen would remove from here, and you will have this anilinium ion, sorry, this aniline. So this aniline now transition from non-bonding to pi antibonding. So obviously this is the loosely held non-bonding, energy gap is low. It will require low energy means high wavelength. So this is now shifting from low wavelength to high wavelength. So this is where actually the red shift. So this is your red shift when going from anilinium to aniline, and it is your blue shift when you are coming from aniline to here, right? So this is where shifts. This is where shift. This I have written here. Shifts towards the longer wavelength. That means 203 to 230 when you are moving from this to this. And hypsochromic, that is the blue shift when you are moving from here to here, right? Blue is having lower wavelength. So this is how you can explain the transition. And this I have explained what is hyperchromic and what is hypochromic. Decrease in the an increase in the absorption intensity is hyperchromic, and it is not n actually, it is, you can cut it here, decrease in the absorption maximum. This I have explained clearly, and it is related, these two are related with the epsilon value.